Kong Mesh is a service mesh that is based on the Kuma open source CNCF project. Kong Mesh supports every environment, including Kubernetes and virtual machine. In this service mesh demo, we will show you how easy it is to get started. We're going to be using Kubernetes as our platform to deployment. We're going to show you how to install control plane, deploy a demo application, and enable basic traffic policies, and briefly touch on observability. Let's get to it. We're going to be using Helm charts to install Kuma Mesh. In order to get started, we need to add a repository that includes Kong Mesh Helm charts. We're going to install Kong Mesh in a separate namespace, so that's why we need to create a Kong Mesh system namespace. Kong Mesh requires enterprise license in order to operate, so that's why we need to create Kubernetes secret that contains information from license file. Helm charts include a template that allows you to configure a secret that will be used during installation in order to configure license. In a control plane portion of this template, we need to enable mesh license inline parameter that will include information how to retrieve this license from Kubernetes secret. Next, we're going to be using Helm install command in order to install Kong Mesh into Kong Mesh system namespace. And we supply values file that we just created together with this command. Let's use kubectl get pods to quickly check the status of this control plane pod. Next, we're gonna using kubectl get services to get a number of ports that this control plane pod exposes. We're gonna be using 45681 in order to get access to UI of this system. For this, we're going to be using kubectl port forwarding command in order to bind the remote service to local port. We're going to be using port 5681 and we navigate our browser to localhost 5681/GUI in order to see Kong Mesh UI. As you can see, there is nothing exciting happened, so we will observe our data planes and there's nothing there because we didn't deploy any pods that will be activated and will be used inside the Kong Mesh. So let's fix that. Kong Mesh based on the Kuma and it includes Kuma control command line utility that allows us to operate and do some interesting things together with Mesh. It also includes set of command that allows to install a bunch of interesting things. We're going to be using kubectl get pods to see the status of this deployment and we can speed up things here. So let's check if we have any services up and running here. Now we see two services that already deployed and different ports are assigned. We're going to be using also kubectl port forwarding in order to get access to web UI of this demo. We exposed port 5000 and now let's navigate our browser there. It is pretty straightforward demo that includes demo application that will increase and auto increment the Redis counter that we'll be storing in our Redis database. And let's keep this running for time being and start doing some interesting experiments. Before we start doing anything exciting here, let's do some boring stuff. Enable security. Kong Mesh allows enable MTLS between components very, very quickly. So when we run kubectl inspect data planes, what we can notice here is that there's no certificates, there's nothing is configured in order to prevent services to be intercepted inside Kubernetes. So let's fix this by enabling MTLS. Let's go ahead and edit default mesh by adding some of the parameters to enable MTLS. Let's create a spec that will include section about MTLS. Kuma and Kong Mesh comes with built-in certificate authority that we will call CA1 and we put the type built-in and we enable this by default. So this certificate authority will be automatically enabled and all these data planes inside our mesh will have its own certificate. As you can see here, when we run this get meshes command, we see that MTLS is enabled on our default mesh. When we run Kuma control inspect data planes again, now we will see that we will have MTLS. And most important thing, that our application is continue up and running. And when we go inside the data planes and check certificate insights from Kuma UI, we'll see that when the certificate was created and when the certificate will expire. When the expiration time will come, Kuma will be responsible for refreshing this certificate, which is nice. So next thing is let's play around with different traffic policies. Before we start doing anything exciting, let's create a backup for our traffic permission. By default, all communication between all services enabled. So each service can go and talk to any service as you normally do. However, we'll show you how we can change that. Our current spec includes information that's a destination and our source would be wildcard. So next thing is that we'll use kubectl to delete this traffic permission, meaning that the services will not be able to communicate to each other and see how this will affect our application. Now we see that our front end won't be able to connect to Redis anymore, and we can quickly fix that by reapplying this traffic policy. And immediately we see a result. You can have a different policies over this traffic, and I encourage you to check our other videos where we're going to be talking about more sophisticated traffic policies. Make sure to check other Kongbooth demos about service mesh. As I mentioned earlier, Kuma control comes with a command called install that allows install different components. And another thing that you can install here is a metric stack. Progress our application development, we want to have a solid observability story. Next thing is that we're also going to be using kubectl port forwarding in order to expose Grafana internal port to our local port. So we can play around with some metrics here. So localhost port 3000, we can access to Grafana. When you install this using kubectl command, you'll have a bunch of cool things, including predefined dashboards that allows us to start introspecting interesting insights in our application. So let's click to this Kuma mesh dashboard. So what we can see here is the service map is empty. It's just simply because we didn't enable any metrics in our service mesh. So let's fix this. We're going into kubectl edit meshes with default, and we modify in specification here. We're adding metrics section here, defining the backend. We're gonna be using a Prometheus to collect our metrics, and we will have a type of Prometheus. The next thing is that we also need to enable this Prometheus 1 backend in order this metrics will be collected by Prometheus scraper. When we get back here and quickly refresh the screen, we will see that our mesh already populated in a dropdown, and we will see our services communicate through service mesh. Our demo application talks to Redis, and we can see it here on the services map. That's pretty neat. That's something that you can learn a little bit more about topology of your application. If you like this demo, go check this out, other demos that are available in our demo booth section. Use this time to learn something new about cloud native connectivity, service mesh, API gateways, and some other exciting technologies. And as always, have a nice day.